Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Life Science with KMD. Today I'm going to explain about fats and oils biosynthesis. Now what are the difference between oils and fats? So the main sources of fat are animal, whereas in case of oil is a plant. Whereas the fatty acid in case of fats are saturated, in case of oil is unsaturated. Obviously, when there is a saturated fat, I mean fatty acid in the fat, then the bonding, that is the double bond, is not present in saturated fats. Whereas in case of oil, there will be a double bond because it has a unsaturated fatty acids. In the state at room temperature, so it will be in a solid state, fat will be in a solid state. Whereas in case of oil, it will be in a liquid state. The melting point in case of fat is high, whereas oil is low, because already it will be in a liquid form, so melting point is low. Now the fatty acid consists of a carboxylic group and a hydrocarbon chain. If this hydrocarbon chain consists of a double bond, then it is called as an unsaturated fatty acid. If this hydrocarbon doesn't have a double bond, then it is called as a saturated fatty acid. Now the saturated fatty acid are less fluid because they are more dense. Since they don't have a double bond, they doesn't produce a kink. If there is a double bond, then it is a saturated fatty acid. Since it has a double bond, it produces a kink in the structure of that fatty acid. So there is no kink in the saturated fatty acid, so they are more densely packed. Since they are more densely packed, they are less fluid. Whereas in case of unsaturated fatty acid, it will be having a double bond, so they produce a kink. Due to the kink, there will be a they are not densely packed, because they are not densely packed, so they form a more fluidity will be there. Usually fatty acids will bound to the 3 carbon glycerol molecule to produce a glycerol lipid. This table represent number of fatty acids. As the number of carbon atom increases, the melting point of the fatty acid also increases. But whenever the double bond of the fatty acid increases, the melting point will decrease. So that we have to notice here. Now what is the difference between animal cell and plant cell with respect to fatty acid synthesis? In case of animal cell, in cytosol, fatty acid synthesis will take place in the cytosol. Whereas in case of plant cell, the fatty acid synthesis takes place in the chloroplast. Even beta oxidation or the fatty acid oxidation takes place in mitochondria in case of animal cell, whereas in case of plant cell, fatty acid oxidation takes place in the peroxisome. But the similarity between animal and plant cell is that in case of fatty acid elongation and desaturation, it takes place in endoplasmic reticulum in both plant cell and animal cell. Now this fatty acid biosynthesis in animals start from acetyl-CoA. Now this acetyl-CoA is a precursor for fatty acid synthesis, is produced by pyruvate, ketogenic amino acid, fatty acid oxidation and by alcohol metabolism. And it acts as a substrate for TCA, ketone bodies, steroid and fatty acid synthesis. Now the acetyl-CoA, which is present in the mitochondrial matrix, cannot directly enter into the cytosol from the mitochondrial matrix. So it has to be converted into citrate. Now this citrate was carried by the citrate transporter, which is present in the mitochondrial inner membrane. And then this will be transferred to the outer membrane. From there it will be transferred to the cytosol. Here this citrate was converted into acetyl-CoA, where this acetyl-CoA will be utilized for the fatty acid synthesis. Now in case of fatty acid synthesis, In the cytoplasm, the ingredient which are required for the fatty acid synthesis are acetyl-CoA, NADPH, carbon dioxide and ATP. These ingredients are present in the cytoplasm. Now, once the acetyl-CoA enter into the cytoplasm, there it will be converted into melanyl-CoA with the help of an enzyme ABC carboxylase with the addition of carbon dioxide and ATP. Now, this melanyl-CoA is converted into fatty acid palmitate, which is a 16 carbon atom with a series of steps. Then this palmitate or the fatty acid will enter into the endoplasmic reticulum, where it will be elongated and desaturation takes place. In case of human, no desaturation beyond carbon 9 atom. So after elongation and desaturation, the fatty acid will be converted into triglycerides. These triglycerides are packed into VLDL. Then this VLDL will take this this fatty acids into the adipose tissue, where it will be stored as a fat. In summary, in this cycle, 6-acetyl-CoA, which is a 2-carbon molecule, plus 7-ATP plus 14-NADPH was utilized for the production of palmitate, which is a 16-carbon molecule, plus 7-ADP plus 7-phosphate plus 14-NADP plus 6 molecule of water and 6-CoA will be produced. Oil biosynthesis in plant. Usually in chloroplast, the light and carbon dioxide from the atmosphere will be utilized for the photosynthesis, photosystem 1 and photosystem 2. Here, first the triose phosphate will be produced. Either it will be converted into hexose phosphate and then it will be converted into starch, or this triose phosphate will be converted into acetyl-CoA, then it will be converted into fatty acyl ACP. This will enter into the cytoplasm and then into the endoplasmic reticulum to produce acetyl-CoA, and acetyl-CoA is converted into diacyl glyceride, then to triacyl glyceride. Now these triacyl glycerides or accumulated in the form of oil bodies in the cytosol. Either this fatty acyl will enter into this pathway, or it could be converted into diacyl glyceride in the chloroplast itself, and then it will be converted into either phospholipid or glycolipid, which helps in the membrane preparation. Oil bodies or oleosomes. Oleosomes. Triacylglycerol accumulate in discrete subcellular organelle called oil bodies. These lipid particles are present in seeds, flower, pollen, fruits of higher plants. These oil bodies has a matrix of triglycerides surrounded by a layer of phospholipid and different proteins. Most of these are oleosin, but others such as calliosin or steroleosin are also present. Oleosin in seed are small protein of about 15 to 26 kilodalton that contain a sequence of 70 to 80 hydrophobic amino acid towards the middle of the protein and have more hydrophilic N and C terminal domain. They completely cover the surface of subcellular oil bodies. Calliosin also appear to play a role in triglyceride mobilization during germination, possibly by facilitating interaction with the vacuoles. Steroleosin, in addition to oil body anchoring domain, possesses a sterol binding hydrogenase that might play an important role in signal transduction. Oil body formation. Oil bodies are derived from the endoplasmic reticulum, but the exact mechanism of their biogenesis is still in question. It has been proposed that the triacylglyceride oil accumulate between the two lipid monolayer of the endoplasmic reticulum and bud to form an oil body at the site defined by the presence of molecule of protein oleocin. See, this is how the oil body will buds out from the endoplasmic reticulum. Tepetosome. There are special oil bodies in the tepetum cells of the anther in Arabidopsis and Brassica. These oilosomes are present in a novel neutral lipid containing organelle, which has been termed the tepetosome because of its unique presence in tepetum. Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a comment box. Thank you.